G'day everyone, welcome back, Grandma's Handbag. So glad you could join us. Here's a helper for all of you. Cheers to you all. Good, strong stuff for summer. Lovely. Sorry I've been away. Want to get straight into this one. Antipodean Archives. This is a little series I've got, intermittent one. I want to kick it up a bit more this year for Australian and New Zealand content. Anyway, what you saw at the start there and heard was the band No Fixed Address, From My Eyes, and what you read was A Welcome to Country. So what this episode is about Aboriginal or Indigenous music of Australia from roughly 1980 to 2000. Just a few bands I've discovered over the past few years and a little bit of story and information about them. And a bit of context and everything like that. So I just want to put out there, by no means am I any kind of expert. I do not profess to be. It's just a journey of discovery of, you know, Australian musical history that I've undertaken. The welcome to or acknowledgement of country, which you saw at the start there, is acknowledgement and acceptance that we are on land that's been... taken from First Nations peoples. And in Australia, I think there's a real pains to say that sovereignty was never ever ceded in Australia. The land was taken by force. So recognising that is an important step, I think, anyway, for Australia to undertake. The turbulence, the damage of dispossession of First Nations peoples, you know, the harm that's caused. In Australia, as well as the Australia Day celebration, there's a lot of mourning that goes on for what's called Invasion Day or a day of mourning. So my wife and I, we went to a little march on Australia Day and ended up at a festival called Yarban. And I'll flash a couple of pictures around here. Celebrating the strength of Indigenous culture in Australia. So, anyway, if we move this along to the music now, there were Aboriginal artists before the ones that I'm showing here, but I guess these artists were just in the same realm of popular and commercial music, and I suppose their point of difference was that they were Indigenous or Aboriginal artists, you know. Jimmy Little is a big one that comes to mind, or Lionel Rose. So just working in the same spheres as everyone else. But the artists I'm really focusing on here are ones that where there's, a real sense of identity of being Aboriginal or Indigenous, and how that pervades the music, you know, this real kind of sense of culture that's being preserved. And very much the struggles of the people being played out through the music. So, I mean, the first one we've got really to break out in Australia were No Fixed Address. This is an EP or mini album that came out in 1982. So the band were around from about, in their first incarnation, 78 to 84. And the music is very much of that time in the sense that, you know, there's rock, there's Australian pub rock element in there, a strong reggae feel, that kind of influence of Bob Marley as it flowed on throughout the world through the late 70s, very much took root here as well. Headed up by Bart Willoughby, and it's a name, his name tends to pop up a little bit as well. He was also in this band, with family members of his. After this, he went on to form Coloured Stone as another band as well. So yeah, definitely got that liberation of punk in there, you know, this fighting for your values sort of thing, and as well as that, reggae giving the voice and the musical voice as well here. It's commercial, but very much on its own terms. So it did actually hit some portion of the charts and things, but I mean, it does not shy away from any lyrical issues. The first song you heard there, "We Have Survived in the White Man's World," And you know you can't change that as a lyric, and it's just very, very powerful stuff. Other songs on here include, you know, Stupid System, I Can't Stand and Look, or Pigs, which is very much about police brutality, you know. Stupid System says, we were here first and now we're treated second, and the government doesn't give a damn. So yeah, a very, very important album. So that's 1982. Around about this time, an important media organisation started called CAAMA, CAMA, or Central Australian Aboriginal Media Association. You know, so they're involved in making radio shows, you know, TV presentations, news, and also doing recording albums. So one early album that came out from them, and I can't give you a taste of this, is Ilkari Maru, only ever on tape, 1984. But the big one that came out of them in 1983 with the first single sung in an Indigenous language in Australia was the Warumpi Band. The song was Jailanguru Pakanu. And yeah, very, very important. If you don't know this, and I'm probably understating it, there's probably hundreds of dialects of Australian Indigenous languages. But to have one in, you know, on record and played on radio, very, very important thing. So the next band, Warumpi Band, you know, a very, very influential early band as well. This album is their first one, came out 1985. You know, and they had a good association with Midnight Oil, for example, who were a fantastic champion of theirs. So people around the world may know Midnight Oil. In 1985, and for the Diesel and Dust album, 1986, I think, or 7, they certainly went around and co-headlined with bands like the Warumpi Band and many more as well, and really looking out for, you know, Indigenous Australian acts and things. So this album here has got the, you know, almost iconic, or certainly a cult Australian hit, Black Fella, White Fella on there. Sit Down Money as well. And just a great early example of, you know, Indigenous voices, Indigenous concerns, but wrapped up in a very commercial, you know, muscular rock kind of sound and feel. Pub rock there, but a real good feel-good boogie element as well, so they could really pull the crowds in and things as well. They had a second album at the time before they wound up for a few years, and this is Warumpi Band Go Bush from 1987, and this has that Jailanguru Pakanu song on here, but also had a almost an Australian anthem song called My Island Home. Beautiful song on there, but yeah, Warumpi Band, very, very important. They could really show that you could, you know, bring this commercial sounding package, you know, to the rest of Australia, and they may have even toured internationally. Don't quote me on that one for sure. What I wanted to get to though was, all this is leading up 1987 to the Bicentenary in 1988, came out with this album, Kev Carmody, Pillars of Society. And this album is an absolute, no two ways about it, blunt answer to the Bicentenary celebrations. You know, just pulls no punches whatsoever. It's been labelled as Australia's best protest folk album, and I find it very, very hard to disagree with that one. You know, it attacks colonisation and injustices, you know, through the lenses of race and class on there. But beneath all that is this real keen desire and an ability to see the world as a better world, or for a better world that could happen. Now, Kev Carmody is fascinating. He was 42 when he put this out as his debut album in 1988. So he just does not mess about. There's no mincing of words, no mistaking his meaning on here, you know. I get a really strong Bob Dylan feel. There's songs like, you know, Black Death's in Custody, And I want to give you a taste of this one here, Attack Attack.
Well, they want to celebrate their invasion of 1788. The whiplash on each convict's back left the valet from each black woman and man. Higher is their passion. Their sexist, racist system stinks. They seek to celebrate subjugation.
Yeah, so you get that early Dylan feel, you know, real hunger and desire for justice. There's a rage and an anger in there as well. But then some of the songs on here, like Black Bess and Jack Dylan, take on a softer, slightly more John Wesley Harding parable feel, you know. Some moral lessons and things to be told in there. And he's got a real commanding storytelling style, you know. He mixes that in with Christian morality. You know, you certainly hear that on songs like Comrade Jesus Christ. And then a beautiful song that he's got here as well. You know, there's almost this gospel touch on there. And I want to share that one with you as well right now, called Thou Shalt Not Steal.
When you talk of conservation, forests, pristine green, 200 years your materialism has stripped the forest clean, and a racist contradiction that's understood by none, mostly there. Left hand holds the Bible, right hand holds a gun, and they taught us, whoa, black woman, thou shalt not steal. Say, yeah, black man, thou shalt not steal. Your Jesus said you're supposed to give the oppressed a better deal. He said to you, yes, black man, thou shalt not steal. Whoa, where I land, you better
heal. So with this album, Kev Carmody really put these issues on the table for national discussion. There's no doubting that at all. Now, Kev Carmody was championed by artists like Paul Kelly, another fairly iconic Australian. They went on and recorded songs together like From Little Things, Big Things Grow, which is another anthem of sorts for Australia, or increasingly so. But a very, very important album. And I do just want to show you that there, which is... This is the 30th anniversary reissue, and just beautifully done in the Australian flag there. You got the red dirt soil, the yellow sun, and the black night sky. Yeah, just very, very well done. Very powerful stuff. So, from there, you know, you got bands like Yothu Yindi, who actually went on, you know, and maybe is the best known Australian Indigenous band worldwide anyway. They had a big hit with Treaty in 1991-92, and it sort of took those tribal rhythms and things of their music and then mixed that in with club beats as well. So there was some exposure in there, but one of the band members by the late 90s had kind of opted out of Yothu Yindi, which was very much a family concern of the Yunupingu family. And what that member was Jeffrey Gurumul Yunupingu, and he started up or had this band called Saltwater Band. So this is their first album. This is a self-released copy from I think about 1998 at the latest 2000, and this is absolutely lovely stuff. I've really been enjoying this one. You've got again that rock feel, definitely a reggae feel in there, and because it's the late 90s, there are some upbeat ska moments. Still a bit of didgeridoo at times as well, but you know, there's definitely the rock, reggae, and ska hybrid. But the reggae's lighter, you know, there's almost that tropical feel, almost the jazzy guitar element at times, quite lovely. I'm thinking Ernest Wranglin style, you know, floating jazz reggae guitar. Very lovely stuff. And there's some ballads on here that have, you know, they're synthesized string beds, but what they actually do is serve to, you know, to highlight Jeffrey Gurumul Yunupingu's voice. And after this, and he did a couple of other albums, but ended up having a solo career for near on a decade, and could easily be now Australia's or one of Australia's greatest Indigenous exports. This is a lovely album, though, as I mentioned, and just some absolutely gorgeous vocals on there as well. So yeah, that's pretty much just what I wanted to share with you. If you want some names for some, you know, Australian artists, very modern or very recent Indigenous artists, Thelma Plum has put an album out called Better in Black, and somehow she's got some a guest by the name of Paul McCartney on there, and I don't think he guessed with just anybody, so she's worth checking out. Dan Sultan's been playing a good rock hybrid for quite a while now. On the hip-hop end of things, there's a lot of good stuff going on. Baker Boy and Briggs, and especially with the brilliant way they've repurposed the Black Flag here, the band AB Original. So I'm assuming they got rights for that, but I think it's just spot on to see that anyway. Look, thank you very much, everyone. Appreciate you checking in. Do intend to be back soon, and hopefully share some more Australian music as the year goes on, and also some just some finds and things that I've been missing as well. Hope you've all been well. Please take care out there. I'll talk to you all soon. Cheers. Hey, Maninga Panga Yalage, Maninga Panga Yalage, Nara! Hop, Nara! Hey, Maninga Panga Yalage, Maninga Panga Yalage, Nara! Hop, Nara! Everyone, let's go! Oh!